So in this video, we'll see how to use Zebra setup utilities from Windows for sending the PRN files you created from Zebra Designer, and also to configure the printer's interface like Ethernet, wireless, and Bluetooth. Okay, so let's go. So here is my Zebra setup utilities. So you should have installed Zebra setup utilities already. If not, you can download it from our support and downloads page from zebra.com. So let me start Zebra setup utilities. So I have ZT610 203 DPI on the top. You can see the printer. So this is my printer. Okay, and it's currently in the ready status. It's communicated via USB to this PC. So let's select this printer and you go to open printer tools. So now to send the PRN files. Okay, so I'll show the PRN file where it is. So this is the PRN file that I'll be sending to the printer. So this 4x2.prn, which is already created by a Zebra Designer. So now to send this to the printer, what I did was, again I repeated, I select this printer, we go to open printer tools. Okay, so now go to action. So last but option is send file. So below you have this option. Once you click the send file, select the browse button, and then on the desktop from this folder I have saved this file. So select that file by double clicking it, and all you have to do is just do a send file and it will be executed by the printer. Okay, so simple. So this is how you send the PRN files you created to the printer. Okay, so then now the next part is to show you how to send it to the latest drivers. Okay, the one that you saw right now is actually the old version of the driver. So if you have downloaded and installed the latest driver, see, the send file option will be completely different. So I select another driver. So this is the latest version of a driver. So you go to open printer tools, same select, I selected the driver and I go to open printer tools now. So how you, the look and feel on the new driver is completely different. Okay, so here people have been struggling to find the tools button. So all you have to do is come to settings, and here is the send file option down below. So same way, you just have to browse, click the browse button, select the PRN file and click the send, it will go to the printer. Okay, so this is how the PRN file is sent to the printer for testing purpose and all. So whatever alignment and all you have to do, you can do it and then test it before it is integrated into the software. So now let's see how to configure the network on the printer. So as you can see on the top, the printer's network indicator is showing in a red color. So that means the printer is not connected as of now. So either wired or wireless. Okay. And the printer is also showing an alert on the screen saying country code not selected. So this can also come if someone has sent a wrong parameters to the printer, and while configuring, he has not selected the country code on the printer. This can come up. Okay. So once we configure the wireless properly, that error should go off. And also the red LED of the network should come back to green. Okay. So let's select the printer. My active printer is 610 selected, and we'll go to configure printer connectivity, the list of menus that we have on the below. Okay. So configure printer connectivity. You have wired, wireless, or Bluetooth as the option. So for us, I have to configure wireless, so select wireless. The same option is what you go through the wired also. Only thing is, wireless wired one, you will not configure the SSID parameter. Only the IP network, IP related settings you will be giving. So wireless, next. And I want to configure a static IP. So before configuring wireless parameters, do note what is the AP settings, your wireless AP settings is currently having. So I just made a note of it. The same way, you also make a note of it and then start configuring the network. The thing to note is that the SSID is case sensitive. Okay, so if your network is showing as 224 with a small D link, you have to enter the same way to the printer's parameter also. Otherwise, the printer will not get connected. Okay, so my network is all are in uppercase, so no worries for me. Okay. So the first one, what you get on the static option is the configuring the host name for the printer. So if you want, you can put a host name to the printer. Otherwise, you can leave it blank. Not a necessity. You can. So I am putting ZT610 as my host name. Why this is required is sometimes there is an application where the application will call the printer by name rather than an IP. Okay. So for such scenarios, you have to put a name to the printer. All right. So I'll just put my IP address. So whatever I configured, 0.233 is going to maybe my static IP, and 22550 is the subnet mask, and gateway is 0.21. Sorry about that. So 192.168.0.1. So always do cross check, because any parameters done wrongly over here, it will go to the printer and you will have to again redo the whole step. Okay. So next is your band. So this you have to be careful. What is the band that your access point is on? You have to configure the same way to the printer as well. So you have multiple options here. So my network AP is BGN 2.4 GHz. So I select this. So all these these are all network related parameters. So your IT team has to give all these settings to you. So based on that only you can configure on the printer. So wrong settings, the printer will not get connected to the network. And you will be wondering whether it's an issue with the printer or on the network, whatever it is. You have to do a cross check with the IT team what is the correct parameter to be set onto the printer. So this is where the country code is selected. So that is why the printer is showing what is the error on the printer as a country code not selected, right? So because of this only. So you select the proper country that the printer is on. So right now I'm in India. So I select the India as the country code. And then the channel list is an optional parameter. So whatever is the channel that the printer is supposed to get connected to the AP, you have to select that particular channel. Otherwise, you can leave it blank. The printer will automatically get connected to the channel. So SSID, so this is what I told. This is case sensitive. So as the AP is broadcasting, select, put the input the information over here, exactly what it is broadcasting. Okay. So security is WPA to PSK. You have multiple security options here. So as the network you are on, select that particular security mode. So minus WPA to PSK. So I select that, say next, and then it will ask for the passkey. So put it in string and then enter the passkey. Okay, so any mistake done here, printer will not get connected after restart. It will still be in red status. Okay. So now the last option is next. So you have this the script being shown here. So this is what the printer will be, the utility will send it to the printer. Okay, so just displaying, and then you have an option either to send it to the printer or you can select it as a file and then save it, and then that can be mailed to someone or it can be archived for that for a future cross-checking purpose or to future restating the printer to the current or whatever the configuration you have set it on. For such purpose, you can give a name to the file and save it and then archive it and keep it across. So for this video purpose, I just select it as a printer. So it directly all this parameter will directly go to the printer. So click finish. So it goes to the printer and the printer will restart automatically, as you can see on the LCD. So once restarted, the printer should get connected to the network. So what I do is I'll just let the printer restart. So in the meanwhile, I'll open one command window, and whatever the IP we set on the printer, let us start pinging on it. Okay. So now the printer's icon should come back to green. So the IP I set on the printer was 0.233233. So let's ping it. So now we can see the printer is pinging on the network. Okay, so obviously the printer is connected to the wireless network. Okay, so this is how you configure the printer with Zebra setup utilities. So I showed both configuring the printer for a network and also how to send the PRN file to the printer directly. Okay, thanks for watching the video.